Good morning, good afternoon, good night, wherever you're watching this from. Welcome to Assem Live. This is Assem Sports. Bright, shiny, beautiful Tuesday. Hope you're having a wonderful week. Thank you for tuning into the one-stop shop for critical, analytical, intellectual conversation when it comes to the beautiful game of football and soccer. And the time has finally come where the Champions League returns with a banger. The quarterfinal games have been scheduled. They are going on today and tomorrow. We're going to talk about that. The Champions League is back and on track, delivering mouth-watering games of football and soccer. Thank you for tuning in to Assem Sports. But before we get to that, there's a pressing issue making rounds in the sports world, in the football world, concerning the Liverpool-Arsenal game in the Premier League. You already know the Premier League is the upper echelon, the creme de la creme. But sometimes the Premier League takes a back seat when it's the Champions League, which we're going to talk about. But events that took down in the Premier League between the Liverpool and Arsenal game, where Andy Robertson, from the footage, it seemed like he was elbowed by a referee's linesman. And that has sparked conversation about the implications of such acts in a game. I mean, if you could describe this Premier League season with one word, it will be chaotic. This season has been full of drama everywhere, from managers being fired to teams and the top four race and just players. There's just a lot going on. But I don't want us to use an innocent person for a scapegoat, to become a victim of fan abuse It is unwarranted for a referee to have physical offensive contact with a player on the field. Players do it too. Alexander Mitrovic has a 7 and 8 game ban because he touched the referee. Bruno Fernandes at the point in time. But you see, I'm saying all this to say the game has gotten so soft. There's a lot of, excuse my friend, bitching. A lot of these players there's a difference between arguing and talking among players in the heat of a game. But there's never been a time in history where a player went to express his frustration to a referee and change the referee's mind. Matter of fact, you're gonna even make it worse. There's a lot of bitching in these players, and even though the referee lifted his elbow, it was more of a shrug. It was more of a shrug, if you watch the footage, than him actually trying to hit him with Robertson with his elbow. And I'm saying that it's a lot of bitching in this season where people are talking to the referee. You will not change the referee's mind. So what is the point of just going to talk to the referee? And some of these teams and these coaches and these players, these little things affect the rhythm and the flow of the game. There's no point in having an argument with the referee. He is the boss on the field. So, like, why do you want to get on the bad side of the referee? I don't understand. But it's a game of passion, but I don't want us to make any big deal out of it. If the referee should serve a ban, maybe a ban. People are calling for the referee to be indefinitely fired. I mean, are you crazy? Everybody's gone so soft. The game is not a soft game. It's the passionate game. And during passionate moments, natural reactions happen. It was a natural reaction. He wasn't really trying to elbow the Robertson grown ass. I mean, he's a grown ass man. He's not a child. You understand me? Anyways, so yes, referee could serve like a little bit of suspension for a couple of games, but people are advocating for a lifetime ban. You out of your mind? That is not going to happen. Thank you for tuning into Assem Sports. Yes, we talked about that in the Premier League. It's very officiating. This season hasn't been that great. I am not here to represent the Referees Association, but I just feel like we should be very honest to the fact that the game is a passionate game. And in action and emotion, things would happen that wasn't intentional. We shouldn't let that referee be a scapegoat because we don't like referees. Thank you for tuning into Assem Sports. We're talking Champions League. Beautiful Tuesday. Champions League is back and the games are going on. Inter Milan is playing Benfica, Romelu Lukaku. This season, Inter Milan is doing well in the Serie A, but one could also argue that the Serie A is not the upper echelon. The competition in the Serie A, even though two Serie A teams are in the quarterfinals of the Champions League, Inter Milan with Romelu Lukaku and The squad are playing against Benfica from Portugal. Manchester City is playing Bayern Munich today. That is going to be the blockbuster game. I mean, the Inter Milan Benfica game here. It might be exciting, but Manchester City against Bayern Munich under the great Thomas Tuchel. His first game in the Champions League. This against Pep Guardiola, who he beat before when he was at Chelsea. This is a match made in heaven. Wonderful Tuesday, Champions League is back and Manchester City is playing Bayern Munich. Tomorrow, Real Madrid is playing Chelsea and Milan is playing Napoli. We're going to talk about those games tomorrow. Thank you for watching Assem Sports. Champions League is back. Like you already know, the Forecast 1.0, a collection of songs by the Musical King. New ASEA Music Collection, the Forecast 1.0, available on all platforms. Click the link in the bio. More music on the way. With the channel coming soon. This has been Assem Sports. Obedante.